Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei channel. Today in this video, I will be demonstrating this morphing effect in HitFilm using the puppet tool. You can purchase the puppet tool as an add-on for HitFilm Express, but it comes standard in HitFilm Pro. So let's take a look at what I did here. Dragging this raw footage into the editor timeline, you can see that I reach out and I set the cup down. Then I move out of frame. Then I go ahead and swap out the cup for the mug, moving out of frame again before I do the snap and pick up the mug. So to do the transfiguration effect, I'm going to go to just after I move out of frame and slice that. And then I'm going to, just before I move back into frame, slice it there. That way I can go ahead and grab this middle piece and right click and just simply ripple delete the object. So now I just have this situation where it changes. Boom. But I don't want it to change there. I want it to change on the snap there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and make a duplicate copy. You can do that by hitting Control and just dragging it up into the video track above it. If there is not one there, it will create one. Now, I don't want two copies of the audio, so I'm just going to go ahead and turn that off. But now I can just drag this over until it is here, so you can see that it will change as soon as that snap happens. The problem is this top layer video is covering the bottom layer footage. So what I need to do is just mask out so that the arm is visible, but not anything else. So I'm going to just simply, using the freehand mask tool, just cut this out so that you can see the hand and the arm, but not the the mug there as well. So that way, now you can see how it is set there, and then I snap and it changes. So that's how that happens, the transfiguration itself, very simple. But how do you get this to morph over time? Well, obviously the morph will begin at the snap. So what will have to happen is I will have to drag this out a little bit further. I'm at 503. I'm going to go to 603, which is 1 second past that. And I will just drag this out a little bit more. So now coming back to 503, I can go ahead and cut that. Okay. So now I have this where it is a clean plate as well as the cup in here. So I can go ahead now and right click on this and make this into a composite shot. And then in this composite shot, I have my clean plate as well as the cup, but I need to have both. So I'm going to right click on that footage and just duplicate it. And then this footage I will go ahead and make into its own composite shot, clicking OK, so that I can cut out just the cup. So I'm going to move in really close and I am going to mask out just the cup. All right, so now that I have just the cup, I can go back to the initial one, and you can see that I have just the cup by itself in this footage, and then I have the entire clean plate in the footage underneath it. So in the footage that is just the cup by itself, I am going to add the puppet tool, and I will click on Generate a Mesh, and if you look at this, I go back to edit, you can see if I have the selection tool selected that there is a mesh here, and I'm just going to up the tessellation to the maximum. This will slow down your computer, so you do have to be a little bit careful. But now at this point, I have the maximum amount of stretchiness that I can get within this. So now what I want to do is go ahead and add in my points around here. And I will do that very carefully. Also, I will want to add points around the lip. The more points that you add, the better, because then it will give you more control over the stretchiness or the morphing of this object. Now that I have done that, I need a copy of the mug itself so that I can stretch that. So let me just find a spot here where the mug is, hit the I for endpoint, and then I will go ahead and just drag this in. So now I know where that mug is. That's only there temporarily. I won't actually end up leaving that in here, but this will allow me to now go ahead and animate these. So I'm going to switch this to animate, and opening up the control points, I'm going to grab them all and I'm going to keyframe those. Then I will go to the end and I will start stretching these out. So what needs to happen here is I just need to start pulling these to where they match the mug itself. So I'm just going to grab these and start by just pulling these to the edge of the mug, and then I will continue to refine that after I've done that. Okay, so now that I've pulled those to the edge, I just need to start pulling them until the rest of the mug is where I need it to be. Okay, now I think that looks pretty good. Yes, it does. All right, so I can go ahead and get rid of the mug footage and turn back on the clean plate footage. So now you can see that this is morphing the way that I want it. Going back to the editor timeline, now it is like that, you see. Okay, now notice that the mask is missing from this footage, so I'm just going to copy it from here and put it on this one. Paste. So now it's there, and that looks good. And now all I need to do is hide this very end piece. So I'm going to do two things. One is I'm going to add a glow effect just to the morph layer. And then two is I'm just going to fade out the opacity of this. So going back into this piece here, that's the layer that I'm looking for. I will add a glow effect to that layer, and then I will go ahead and animate that. So I'm going to go to the end and I'm going to back up about 10 frames and click keyframing for the intensity, take that down to 0, move to the end, and then increase that until it's about right, maybe adjust this slightly. Okay, that looks pretty good. Going back out to the main editor timeline, you can now see that it is expanding in this manner. And so what I need to do is just back up also maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 or so and click on the opacity. Then we'll take that down to 0. So now it is just sort of fading out as the glow happens as well. And that is pretty much how that is done. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.